Hey guys, Mr. Kyle, Myers Mathematics, and let's jump right back into it. Number 15 on this worksheet of solving systems of equations by substitution. Well, we can solve for y pretty easily here. I'm going to switch it up. I've been doing red and blue for the past few, so I'm going to do blue and yellow this time. What do I mean by that? You'll see. So we're going to solve for y in this one. Whenever you're trying to solve or pick a variable to solve for, I recommend picking one that's already kind of by itself. The y is already kind of by itself. So I get rid of the stuff around it. That way it's only taking one step to solve for y. Okay, so it's less work that way. Speaking of things that are less work, if I look at this other equation, which I'll make blue, I can divide all of that by 6 and make my life a little easier. All of those things are 6s. So, and even if they weren't all 6s, as long as they were multiples of 6, I could divide all of them by 6 and make my equation a little easier to digest here. So this is going to be x plus y equals negative 1. Much easier equation. Now I'm ready to plug in my y into the blue equation. So I'm going to plug that in. So it's going to be x plus. And then instead of y, I'm going to put what y is equal to in the yellow equation. And it's still going to be equal to negative 1. So that's going to be y, which is equal to negative 5x minus 13. And that is how substitution works. Then blue and yellow make green. So the rest of this is going to be green. X plus negative 5x is negative 4x. Minus a 13 still. That doesn't combine with anything. Add 13 to both sides. So adding 13 to negative 1 would be the same thing as 13 minus 1, which is 12. So x is negative 3. Then I plug that back in to get y. Don't forget to plug in your answer. So when you're solving for system, you've got a system of equations. What you're trying to do is figure out x and y most of the time. Not all the time, but most of the time. They want both. They want both the x and the y. So don't forget to find both answers. Don't stop once you've got x or y solved for. Make sure you get both of them because they typically want both of the answers. So negative 5 times negative 3 is positive 15. Minus 13 is going to be 2. So now I have x and y, and then I'm done. Unless I wanted to check it. If I wanted to check it, I just plug those things back into the blue equation. And because I simplified the blue equation, it's a little easier to figure out what's going on there. It would just be negative 3 plus 2 is equal to negative 1, which is true. So there we go. And we checked it without having to write anything. So lots of confidence in that answer. That's really all there is to it. So hopefully that's been helpful. Let me know if you're missing any of these numbers. All of these should be up on YouTube at some point in the near future. So let me know if you don't see any of them or if you're looking for a solution to some other question that's similar to this but not on this worksheet. Just let me know. Shoot it in the comments below. I'd be happy to work it out for you. You can put a picture of the problem or you can email me a picture of the problem. I've got my email in the description below as well because I do private tutoring. So that way you can shoot me an email if you want to set up tutoring. I do my first hour lesson for free always. And yeah, that's everything I can think of. Other than I've got some resources on my website as well, like the 5 math mistakes everyone makes and how to avoid them. So go to MyersMathematics.com, link in the description below. Go check out some stuff that I've got up on my website. And I hope that's helpful. So yeah, have a great day. And I'll see you in the next video real soon.